that we may always work to connect peace on earth and goodwill toward all people with the nonviolent affirmation of the sacredness of all human life.
A beautiful morning who invite us to go to our closet to bring things that keep us warm. It's a day who invite us to go there and to find something that maybe we don't use so often. Find that little thing there who will warm us, that we can be able to go out and enjoy the beautiful day. And that is why we are coming today to celebrate the memorial of Martin Luther King, Dr. Martin Luther King. It's helped us to go a little bit back, to see the example of someone who was able to find the new wine, to find the hope, to bring hope, to make the people be free to dream. We don't sometimes have problems to have a dream. We are not free. And that is why sometimes life loses the taste. The freedom to dream for something better. Beginning with our own selves, start with our own hearts. How free are we to dream in something better? Because that is what gives us hope. And that dream needs to come with enlightenment, with the light of our faith, in the way that Jesus is giving us and show us his way to be free. That was what Dr. Martin Luther King was looking for, to help his people to be free and be able to dream for a better future. And he paid his dream with his life. He was unable to see the fruits of what he did, but help his people to embrace and be free. And that is the mission that we have in our own faith, all of us. Always we have minorities in the middle of our country. Always we have people, new people coming from another countries that they don't feel at home, or they have difficulties to get along. But from the lessons that we learn from the past, how we can create a nation who is united by one dream, freedom for all of us, and embrace each one of us. Doesn't matter the color, the race, or where you're coming from. All of us, we are sons and daughters of God. We're looking for something better, and that needs to become a dream. How all of us together and have a common dream of peace, unity, and love. But for that, we need to surrender first ourselves to the mercy of the Lord. That to see how He, the Lord, make us free us first, make us free our own hearts. Give us the joy in embracing Him to be able to embrace someone else. That, I think, is one of the important things. Find first our own freedom in our own heart. Free from what? From envy, discrimination. All of these things that separate us. and embrace the beauty of the human person. That we are so diverse that is the richness of what we are. Each one of us we have our own beautiful treasure in our hearts that we're put in there by Jesus that we can enrich the life of someone else. How we, as a nation, as a people, are able to go first and find with difficulties, yes, first, by going and make a journey to our own hearts and asking God to give us the freedom to be who we are. And be free to have a dream. And share that. And encourage the people to make the same thing. To embrace the possibility to be free and have a dream. That is what moves us. The Lord is looking to put his new wine and is looking for a new heart that he, with a new wine, can give us the joy of living our lives. A good cup of wine is tasty and is good. And that is what Jesus, with his love, is looking for, that heart who is willing to be open to receive the wine of his love. And tasting that wine that is Jesus himself with his love in our own hearts, in our own lives, we can experience the true freedom of beloved and feel special and help another person to make the same journey. Not to change them, but helping them to be who they are. And respecting each other for the gift that each one of us we have, our own dignity as a person, as a human being. Doesn't matter what we are, where we're coming from, what language we speak, but all of us we have, and we are sons of God. How beautiful is that? And how we can, all of us, become messengers and assume the challenge that once times Dr. Martin Quinn assumed to guide his people in that journey of freedom that was not easy, but he was looking for the best of them and opened for them a window to dream. Sometimes we are afraid to dream with our own selves and afraid to make the journey of our own lives. But Jesus is there in front of us, looking to help us, to put the new wine in our own hearts and give us the taste, the beautiful, great taste of what is true life, true freedom, and open ourselves to be able to dream for peace, justice, and love for all of us. We are here to celebrate. It's a celebration of a great gift that all of us we need to embrace is the gift of life and freedom. And the only one who can give us that is our Lord Jesus Christ, when we allow him to go in front of us, touching us, and make us instruments of his service, as Dr. Martin King was for his people at his time, who give them the freedom to start to have a dream.